What's the biggest question I get when building models in my reviews? Chris, how do you get such a shiny paint job? How do you get the paint shiny? How do you make it gloss and smooth? You must use an airbrush. You must decant automotive paints. You must spray them up. Well, no, actually. Most of my builds, and I do use an airbrush, but I want to let you know out there in model world, you don't have to have an airbrush to have nice, shiny car models, to paint military models. You don't need it. I'm going to show you how, using cheap spray cans, you can get yourself shiny looking models. One of the very first steps I like to take is cleaning off my models. Now, what I do is I give them a soak in warm water, not hot. I don't want to warp or melt the body at all. So I put them in a dollar store tub. I use an old toothbrush and I give all the plastic a nice scrub and any sort of degreaser. Now, what I like to use is called Jungle Jake. It's from Fleet Farm. You can use Simple Green. You can use Purple Power, whatever you want, as long as it degreases it. Modern molds, you really don't have to worry a lot about a lot of oil and grease on them, especially American kits and stuff like that. The molds are in pretty good shape. They don't have to grease them all up, but it's still a good thing to get most of it off the body. So all you do is just use your old toothbrush from back in the day when you used to brush your teeth and you don't anymore. And that might explain why some of you guys are single out there. And all you have to do is just scrub the bodies. And you don't have to get rough. You don't have to break anything off. You don't have to destroy. I do inside and out, by the way. So we'll just go through in that warm water and we'll go ahead and we'll get our hood all scrubbed up and we just let everything soak in there after scrubbing for maybe 30 minutes at the most, sometimes shorter depending on how much of a hurry I'm in. But that will ensure that nothing is really sticking on the body too much. If there did have to be some grease, what if the guy at the factory had a big ham sandwich just before he went back to pulling things out of the mold? You never know. So anyways, use your Jungle Jake, use your Simple Green, and get in there and get that body scrubbed and make sure that it does have a chance to soak and get completely degreased, and then we can move on to the next step, which is going to be applying some primer. The next step to a spray can glossy paint job is, of course, first, let the body dry. Don't rush this. Wipe it off with a clean, lint-free rag. Old t-shirts work really well because they're usually pretty lint-free by then. Then I use my preferred primer. Now I want to do a light color of paint on this body, so I'm going to use a white primer. Now just on this one, just so I can keep it consistent, I'm going to use a Rust-Oleum Ultra White Flat Primer. That doesn't mean you have to use Rust-Oleum primers with Rust-Oleum paints. It's just what I happen to have on hand as a white primer. You can use CarQuest or Advanced Auto gray primer, black primer, Rust-Oleum primers, Krylon primers. It really doesn't seem to make a difference when I'm working. Everything seems to work for me. So what you want to do first is I use this little paint booth. You saw me review this quite a while ago. This is what I use to keep dust down. It doesn't vent out anywhere, so I have to wear a mask. And this one, I've got the room really well ventilated right now because I want to be able to talk while I'm doing it. So normally I'd have gloves on and I'd have a mask on, but I'm going to sacrifice myself a little bit for you guys and we'll see what happens here. But first up, we're going to do the hood. So we're going to turn the spray booth on just so it pulls all that particulate out of there. And we're going to shake the can really, really well. You can't shake a paint can too many times. And we're going to apply our primer coat to the hood and then the body in quick succession. Okay, we're getting paint. Just apply enough to grab the body. Don't hose it down, okay? Don't give it 18 layers of primer. That's enough. We're gonna put that aside. Now we're gonna do the main body. Make sure you continuously shake your can up. I'm gonna go down and work my way up. There are a million ways, as I said, to paint something. If somebody else likes doing it a different way, cool on you. This is how I do mine, and that's why I'm showing it, because people have asked. Now I'm just giving it a nice consistent coat of white primer just to get everything on there. And now we're gonna let that sit and dry for at least 2 hours. All right, we're gonna shut the paint booth off. We're gonna let that sit still. We're not gonna mess with it. We're not gonna screw with anything. We're gonna let that dry and we'll be back. Next up, after our primer is hardened up, is what we want to do is we want to get our top coat on our body. And there's some steps that I like to do to make sure that my top coat goes on. Now, of course, everyone's going to have mistakes, so nothing is perfect in this world. But one of the things, because my shop is in my basement is not heated, and this is Wisconsin in the winter, it gets pretty cold down here. I think the current temperature is about 50 degrees in the shop, which is a little cold for shooting paint, but it'll still work. What I like to do is warm up the body with a heat gun. Now, these I use for model airplanes to shrink the cover. You can get them anywhere you want. They're really cheap. If you get the ones for the hardware usage, for the hardware stores that are much bigger and they get much hotter, just hold it farther away. But in this case, I can warm up the body and I can warm up the paint on the body to a nice temperature, usually around 100 degrees, you know, 90, 100 body temperature is what we'll say. And that helps with a lot. Now also, while this is doing this, about 10 minutes ago, I threw my top coat paint color into a vat of hot water. So we'll shut the fan off. Now we'll go get my spray can way back here in the wash tub, and it's been soaking in hot water right from the tap. Don't boil it or anything, but just hot water from the tap. And we're gonna be doing that beautiful seaside gloss that we saw before. Now you'll see, we'll do it 82 degrees. Now that's a nice warm temperature for the paint. So we're going to shake that up really nice. We're going to get Mr. Body here out of the way so he doesn't get hit with any spray. We're going to shake it up well. We're going to get our fan going. And we're going to hit our hood. First we'll do the bottom because we only do the bottom once. We don't worry about a gloss. Ooh, yummy. All right, now we're going to do the top of the hood. Make sure you get your edges. All right, and that's that. We're gonna put that on the side. We're gonna bring our body over. We're gonna give our can a good shake again. And it's nice and warm in there. And we're gonna go push the nozzle all the way down so we get paint out. And we got that going like so. Look at all that paint covers, isn't that nice? We do the front and the back, just to make sure we didn't miss any roof trim or anything like that. But you see I'm not hosing the body down with color. I'm taking a look at it, I'm getting it where I need to get it, and that's it. Now, the most important step when you have your top coat on is walk away, all right? Shut off your air cleaner, shut off your booth, because you don't want to suck dust in towards the body after this point. And now go have lunch. Go do something, all right? We have one more step coming for this body, and that's a clear, but that's 2 hours away. Let the Rust-Oleum, let the spray can, the cheap spray can paint set up. You can see how nice it looks, all right? Nice looking body there. Love that color. And we're just gonna let that set up and start curing. For a couple hours, after a couple hours, we're going to come back and hit it with the gloss, and we'll be back for that too. After a couple hours, that beautiful color is hardened up, and it's ready for the clear coat. You can see, just all by itself, you can see that light above it flashing on it. It's a nice paint job. It is not perfect. Of course, you could wait a few days for this to completely gas and harden out, and then sand it and wet sand it, and that's all your preference. If you like doing that, I'm glad you do. I've seen paint jobs by the guys that, you know, super sand it and do all their stuff with it, and they just look amazing. But you guys wanted to know, you've asked me a million times, how do I do it on my show? This is how I do it. And even out of the can, you get a nice glossy factory finish almost. Nothing is absolutely perfect if you look at a real car in the real world, unless it's a show car that they've spent hours and hours and hours and weeks on. It's not perfect. Well, now we're gonna clear coat it. And of course, that's super easy to do. I'm just using the old Rust-Oleum clear again, because this is about how to do it with cheap paint cans. Now, we're gonna shake that up real nice. I did warm the can up just like I do when I warm the top coat up. I do not warm up the primer coat, but the top coat and the clear coat I do warm up in a hot glass of water right out of the tap. Don't use boiling water or it will explode. Now you may get some runs and drips with the clear coat. That's all right, it'll even itself out as it goes. So once again, we're gonna move the body aside. We're gonna turn on our paint booth. We're going to get the hood in there. And I don't clear the bottom. Look at that. Glossy. Let's put that to the side. Let's get out our body. Push that down so it's a little more level. A lot of flat surface area on this huge Buick. And that's why I wanted to use this body, because it is an absolute monster. There we go. Press the button all the way down on the top on the nozzle. You don't want to get a half spray. One over the back. One over the front. That's it. We're done. We've clear coated the model. We've got our shiny coats on there. We're going to let that sit. You can see how nice and sheen, shiny that's getting already. So we're just going to let that sit for 24 hours. 2-4 hours. 24 hours. We're not going to look at it. We're not going to come over. We're not going to mess with it. We're going to leave it in its own nice little covered area in here, in the paint booth area. And I'm going to go work on other parts of my model. This is just a tutorial on how to do the bodies. We'll leave it in there. It's nice and covered. No dust is going to get to it. We'll come back to take a look at that final shiny coat when we're all done. And that's it. After 24 hours, we have a glossy paint finish. And you guys have been asking for quite a while, how do I get my paint jobs to shine? Well, I get them to shine almost, you know, close to a factory paint job. I don't buff, I don't sand, I don't wet sand, I don't do anything. It's a very quick prep. I like to produce my models quickly, and I like to get a shine on them and a nice even paint job, and then I like to move on. I don't try to go for that super duper show finish on my cars. I don't go for the crazy shine. I go for the nice model shine that will look good on a shelf and look realistic for me. It turns out really well. We can turn down some of the lights so we can get some of the truer color on there. You can see that I wanted to shine up the lights to get a lot of shine, but just using three inexpensive products, it's just that easy. It doesn't have to be hard to build models. We have a $3 can of primer, a $3 can of paint, and a $2.95, under $3, can of clear. All from the same company. They don't have to be from the same company. Now, if you really want to give a model a crazy amount of shine and a really hard shine coat after you put all your decals on, that's when this bad boy comes in. All right? Pledge Floor Care. It used to be called Future Floor Polish. It's called all different names, but this is exactly what you want, and all you have to do is apply it with a brush when you're done. You've asked about that as well. So we'll just set it back here. Let me demonstrate the super secret technique for applying Future Floor Polish. You dip the paintbrush into the Future Floor Polish and you brush it on the model. Then you get more and you brush it on the model, and then you walk away for 2 more hours and it dries solid, it dries crystal clear and gives you a nice fancy shine. But this right here, these three steps, easy steps, warming up the paint cans is very important. Warming up the body with a heat gun is important if it is cool outside, and you will get yourself a more than competent, nice looking shine on a model car that you can be proud of. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.